You're watching Model Aviator, I'm Adam, and this one is an airplane that has been on my list for quite some time. I've always wanted a Super Decathlon. Long as I've been in this hobby, I've never owned one. From what I hear, OMP makes about one of the best ones out there. So, we ordered the plug and play, and we are going to see. Let's get after it. So our first impression of the Decathlon was good right off the bat. I picked the shipping package up and thought, holy crap, this is heavy. What's going on here? Turns out there was a good reason for it. When I got into it, there's a cardboard box that the actual aircraft box goes into. And on all six sides of that aircraft box, there's this thick, strong particle board to make it puncture proof, which is awesome. And it works good so the shipper can run into a corner and nothing is going to puncture your aircraft box and doink or otherwise damage a part of the airplane. Also, inside the box, there's all kinds of foam surrounding all the important bits. There's foam covering your servo and servo arms, your control horns, even the horizontal, the attach points on both sides for the bracing wires. Got foam covering it to keep those things from getting damaged. So it was really awesome. The finish, the covering job is just absolutely splendid. Really, really pleased with the quality of this. We're not going to do a build video because there's several of them out there. It's been done and it's been done well. So if you want to check out a more detailed build video, they're out there. What we are going to do is point out one thing that we're going to do that I'm not sure if anybody's pointed out yet. You have a top hatch that you can remove here. We're going to take that off. We're going to take off our normal hatch. We're going to remove our cowling and our spinner. And we're going to go in, and everywhere that one piece of wood touches another, every single puzzle piece, every joint in the motor box, the battery box, where the gear mounts, as well as inside up here where the wing attaches and the wing tube goes through, we're going to seep thin CA on all of those joints just to make sure that everything is properly glued and reinforced. Won't add much weight at all, if any. But will make it much, much stronger. And that's something you should do, again, with any ARF, whether it's a plug-and-play or a true ARF. If it's made of balsa, when you pull it out of the box, that's something that you're going to want to do. So we just wanted to point that out. If there's anything earth-shattering that we run into with the build, we'll, of course, tell you. Otherwise, the next time you see me and this, it'll be on the bench ready to rock and roll. And there we go. She is ready to rock and roll and looking good. I tell you what, this OMP Super Decathlon, I think, is a really good example of a sports scale Super Decathlon. Clearly, they have taken some liberties with the lines to make it fly better as a model, but they've been tactical about it, and it really takes a trained eye to tell what they did. It looks pretty scale as far as the line is concerned, and grooving through the air, making the airplane look scale in the air like an actual Super Decathlon, pretty easy with this airplane. It has some pretty cool features. You've got LEDs, there's landing lights underneath on the front cowling that are on full time. The wing lights you can assign to a switch. You have a choice from off, on, and strobing, which is pretty cool. I love the fact that it's convenient. It's a top loader, and the top hatch is very nice. It looks just like an integral part of the airplane. You can't even tell it's a hatch until you pull it off. And when you do, it exposes a pretty nice battery bay where you can get anything from a 2200 to a 4000 in there, which is nice. It also has a secondary top hatch that allows you to access your wing bolts should you need to store this airplane and transport it disassembled. Now, one of the first things that I noticed when I took a look at this airplane, just holding the parts, and then after I got it together and felt the weight of it, it just solidified what I thought all along. When I look at the construction of this airplane, the way it is just put together, the construction of the wood, the type of wood, where the reinforcement is, the oversized control surfaces, the exorbitant amount of throw, it screams 3D plane to me. I am very familiar with some of the dedicated 3D companies out there that all they do is make 3D planes, and some of them make some civilian airplanes, but they're really 3D planes. The way they construct an airplane the lightweight that they use, how strong the airplanes are for flight loads, the way they do the surfaces, this is how they would do it if they were going to build a Super Decathlon. So that really had me curious as to how capable this airplane would be if you decided to really get aggressive and throw it around. More on that later. Right now, first things first, let's talk about the assembly. The OMP Super Decathlon will come with some decals from the distributor if you decide that you want to use those. Everything else is already there. It comes with an instruction manual that is pretty complete, and assembling this thing is pretty much like assembling a plug-and-play foam model. There's really not a whole lot to it. Obviously, all the electronics are already installed. The only thing you need to install electronic-wise is your receiver, and given the fact that it has the top loading hatch and the top hatch, there's room to actually get two hands in there, and it makes doing that pretty doggone easy. Obviously, you have to install the prop, the gear, your wings, your struts. You have to install your horizontal and the bracing wires. You have to hinge your rudder, which is not difficult at all, and they give a pretty good account of how to do that in the instructions. The only thing that we really ran into that you might not be familiar with if all you ever built is a foamy is installing the horizontal. When you slide that in place, it's pretty tight. It only goes in there one way, and there's not really much moving it once you get it there. Now, they do tell you in the manual something that you should do with any ARF, and that is when you slide that horizontal in, before you glue it in place, you want to put your wing tube in, get behind the airplane, and make sure that the horizontal relative to the wing tube, that they're parallel, so that you know that your horizontal is straight. What they don't tell you, however, is if it isn't straight, what to do about it, and ours was not straight. We had a situation where it was a bit cockeyed. The right side was up, left side was down. So the way that you fix that, or at least the way we fix that, there may be other ways to do it. We're just going to tell you how we did it, worked good, but it's probably not the only way to do it. We took business card stock, just took a business card, slid it in between the crack where the horizontal and the fuselage meet on the top right and the bottom left. Then I took a look and I could see that that got it straight. That shimmed it so that it was perfectly aligned with the wing tube. So then you just mark it, pull it out, cut it, put it back in there, double check it, and then glue it in place. We just seeped thin CA in there, and that will permanently bond that horizontal and the cardstock right where it is. Won't go anywhere. You don't have to use epoxy. And if you did use epoxy, it'd be messy because it's so tight. There's not really any place to put it. And as light as this airplane is, you don't need epoxy. Thin CA will do just fine. So that is really the only thing that we ran into. Everything else, the fit and finish was great. Pretty simple. If you have put together one of the older or more complicated plug-and-play foamies, you can get this thing together, no problem. Okay, now we're going to get to the setup, and that's where this airplane was a little bit interesting for me. I had to do something that I don't normally do to get this airplane to fly the way I wanted it to in the two regimes that I intended to fly in. We'll talk more about that in a second, but first, ours came with a 13.7. This airplane could be flown on 3S or 4S. Anything 13 is going to be for the 3S. We changed to a APC 12.6 to fly it on 4S. The other interesting thing is that this manual does not list a balance point to start with. So we just measured 30% the quarter of the wing and started there. And the intention was, and what we did was to fly and test and see where we'd end up with the balance, and that is exactly what we did. Now, when it comes to the batteries that we use, we gave it a pretty extensive test. We flew on a 2200, a 2600, a 3200, a 3300, and a 3700. Now, you'll notice some different connectors. The Super Decathlon comes with an XT60. You can plug EC3s into that, and we just use an adapter for the battery that has the Dean's connector. Now, what we found is that the sweet spot was the 32 and the 3300. That's what we like the best. With those batteries, it cut a really good solid line, had enough mass to cut a good line when you're doing the scale and the precision stuff. It had enough mass to rotate pretty good if you decided that you wanted to tumble it, of which it will do, and you'll see. And it was still light enough to have a good stall characteristic and do some of the 3D stuff, the hovering and punch out of the hover and whatnot. Plenty of power with this airplane. The 3700 was just, it just felt too heavy to me. It felt a little bit like a pig with that. I could really feel the added mass, and it was just too much to me for what we wanted to do. And the flight regime that we wanted was to be able to fly at scale and just do scale Super Decathlon aerobatics. But we also wanted to be able to, if we got a wild hair, do some tumbling and some 3D and really get aggressive with it. And that is where this airplane is a little bit different. And this was a teaching moment for me. I learned something, and I'm going to share with you what I learned. I'm friends with a gentleman that is a designer for one of the best 3D companies on the planet. And I had a conversation with him about airplanes like this, this particular airplane and some other airplanes. When it comes to setting an airplane up so that you can do precise stuff and 3D and XA stuff, essentially what I want to do runs the gamut of freestyle. Essentially, scale aerobatics would be the precision part of freestyle that you would do with a normal 3D plane. And then, of course, the XA and the 3D are the other two parts of it. Well, the normal 3D plane, you typically can set up full-on 3D tumble rate throws and get your expo up high enough to where what you have is an airplane that's very smooth and precise around center stick and very aggressive out to the extremes, and it's very easy to do the precision stuff. You don't need two rates to do that, in other words. Well, I was having a hard time doing that with this, and what he was telling me is that has everything to do with incidence. With a normal 3D plane like an Edge or an Extra, most 3D companies, despite where the wing placement might be on the full-scale aircraft, will put everything in a line. So your thrust line, your main flying wing, and your horizontal will be 0, 0, 0. Well, with a Super Decathlon, the lowest point is your thrust line. The horizontal is a little bit higher than that, and the main flying wing is higher still than that. So you have three different points. And it is that part of this airplane that makes it difficult to be very, very smooth when you have full-on 3D rates. I could make this airplane fly well doing the more aggressive part of freestyle stuff, but when I wanted to fly at scale, I could do it. But I was struggling to be really smooth because of how sensitive it was, particularly in pitch and aileron. So what we ended up having to do, and what you'll see on the setup page, is we have two rates, which is not something I normally do. We have a scale rate and we have an aggressive rate. Works out pretty good. We use the same battery for both. I was doing a lighter battery and a heavier battery, but I started experimenting with the 32 and 3300s. Turns out I like those the best. So I don't change batteries or battery position. All you have to do is flip a switch to go from one to the other. So check out the setup page. We've got our scale and our aggressive setup on there for the 32 and 3300 four cells. We'll point out that we've got the 12.6 prop for the four cells. And then check out this flight footage. You'll see our maiden. Well, you'll see the takeoff and the landing of the maiden, and you'll see the stall test. Just know that we stalled the airplane with every one of these batteries. The stall characteristics don't change. It just stalls a little bit faster as you progressively get the airplane heavier with the heavier batteries, but the stall's the same. It drops the same wing the same way regardless of the battery. And then you'll see a flight where we start out flying fairly scale, and by the end of it, we'll show you what this thing will do. And then after that, we'll come back here and we'll sum it up. So check it out. This is our maiden takeoff, and then we'll go right into the stall tests and then our maiden landing. Thank you. here's our stall test. It's worth noting that regardless of the battery used or the amount of throw, it always dropped to the left wing. The Super Decathlon has a really responsive rudder, but as far as ground handling is concerned, taking off and landing isn't any more difficult than any other high-wing civil aviation model you've flown. Not really a lot to tell here. The first part of this flight is going to be more scale-ish, if you will, and then we'll get aggressive in the latter part of the flight. For the first part of this flight, we're in the scale rates. When we flip it into the aggressive rates, I'll let you know, and it'll be pretty obvious. Most high-wing airplanes have a good bit of coupling and knife edge, and the Super Decathlon is no exception. But it does seem like it's a little less correction than normal, and that's probably due to the really large control surfaces.
We edited in those last two maneuvers from a previous flight because I forgot to do them on this one. Interestingly enough, the Super Decathlon is more sensitive to down elevator inputs than up. That'll keep you on your toes when you invert it. We're going to do a little slip to landing here, and then we'll flip that magic switch into the aggressive mode and show you what this thing will really do. At over 200 watts per pound, there's enough on tap to do anything you want to do. Obviously, this isn't a full-on 3D machine, but inverted flat spins, pop-tops, crankshafts, hovers are easily done with this, and considering what it is, that's pretty good.
That was every bit as much fun as it was. I like this airplane. I really do. So there's one thing that I wanted to explain really quick that I didn't touch on in the setup. You might take a look at that setup and go, okay, why'd you use two rates? Why not just throw a bunch of expo at it with the higher rate and fix it that way? And here is the reason. With some airplanes, you get to a point of expo and that's not enough. And then when you go past that, it starts feeling like that's too much and the airplane starts feeling sluggish and not reacting to inputs the way that it should. That can be two things. It could be something in the setup. It could be maybe the balance point or the amount of throw you're using or something like that. The other thing, it could just be the nature of the beast. With this particular airplane, the incidence of this airplane is the reason we had to do that. I did throw a bunch of expo at it. It didn't work, and that's why we went with the dual rates. So, that said, who is this for? Well, you could dial this back way back and use it as a trainer if you want to, although I wouldn't recommend that, simply because there are EPO trainers available. And EPO can withstand the hard knocks that a beginner puts it through more so than a Balsa airplane. You can have a crash with an EPO that'll be kind of a minor-ish repair, and if you have that same crash with a super light Balsa plane like this, and that's a major repair, that's the downside of this type of construction. A lot of your 3D plane type builds like this that are super, super light, they can take the flight loads just fine, but when you hit the ground, they don't take those so well. So we'd recommend something else for a beginner. I think that for the intermediate and advanced pilot, regardless of what you want to do, whether you want to fly circles, do scale aerobatics, get crazy aggressive with it and do some XA stuff with it, it will do all that and you will have an absolute blast with this airplane. Setup is kind of crucial, but you know, that's true of a lot of airplanes, and when you get it right, the payoff is pretty awesome. And that's pretty much how we feel about this airplane. I love this thing. When it comes to the negatives, I can't really consider having to use two rates and the way that I had to set the airplane up a negative, because to be fair, it's a super decathlon. What I want to do with it, the more aggressive stuff, that's not really scale. That's not what a super decathlon is intended for. So I can't blame the airplane for the fact that it won't do something that it wasn't designed to do. I'm forcing it to do that. And it says a lot about the airplane, the fact that it will do it if you get the setup right and force it. So that's actually a positive. The only negative I can really think of is the fact that that horizontal didn't go on straight and the fact that the instructions don't tell you how to fix it. Also would like to see a balance point on here and a little bit more setup information. You know, I knew exactly what to do to get started, but some people might not. Be helpful if it was there. But that is pretty much it. Everything else is pretty much bliss. I love this thing. I'm glad we have a super decathlon in the hangar now, and I'm going to enjoy flying this thing for a long time. So if you would like to enjoy one, we will leave a link in the description where you can order one of these yourself. Please like, comment, and subscribe if you haven't. It doesn't cost you anything. It helps our channel, and we love to get the participation from you folks. We really appreciate it. So take care of yourselves. Happy flying, and we will see you next week with something else cool with wings. And who knows, they may, you know, swing or something. You never know.